Jose Carlos Santos from Angola, here in Rome, representing Asled Angola. Asled Angola is an innovation hub that is dealing with challenges, mainly in three verticals, mobility and logistics, fintechs, and also trying to solve problems in agritech. We believe that the potential of innovation and with startups within Luanda can really broaden up and scale to different markets. It's interesting to be coming to Rome and meeting different people, meeting different ecosystem builders, meeting different agendas, so we can link up what we have in terms of potential, Angola, to the rest of the world. As of innovation, it's really different looking at different countries and how innovation is coming about. And I believe just the challenges that we have will present huge solutions for the future. So this is the impact that we're trying to bring. And it has been an interesting week to be here.
This is the third year that we have a panel, a conference about the ecosystem of the startups. We have a special guest from Angola. What is your role in the startup system in Angola?
So first of all, we started building the startup ecosystem with a huge layer, which was community. And building community has enabled us to reach broader frontiers. We host Global Entrepreneurship Week in Jan, Global Entrepreneurship Network. We host Startup Grind Luanda. We hosted Fuck Up Nights Luanda, and also a whole bunch of other events to really engage people into what are startups, what are ecosystems. Over that, we have been working on innovation, open innovation especially, and obviously this will enable more startups to come into programs or accelerator programs or either other programs to be building this right mentality. It was really interesting to be in the panel because it shows that showed us that the world becomes smaller, right? Once you connect the ecosystems, the world becomes smaller. And we are a very diverse ecosystem. And we want to enable more exchanges. We want to enable more startups to come from everywhere to Angola to resolve our issues, but bigger issues that can be African or worldwide issues. So building ecosystems, for me, it's more than the ecosystem itself. It's pulling the strings and pulling together all the actors that can really influence a better future for us.
Angola is a huge oil producer and probably the largest in Africa. Do you think your government is helping the development of this ecosystem of startups? Is doing really something good? Is doing a good job? In Italy, they speak a lot, but they do not do a good job. What about Angola?
In Angola, they speak even more than Italy, but I believe they're going to do a good job. So the role has been really shifting because we have been able to call their attention to the importance of this. And on the long run, they know they're not going to be able to job create the same way a startup or new companies can do it. And they're really stuck with the oil disease, I would say. It's really bad for society because we had a huge corruption on the country. We had government people who didn't understand the necessity of building companies, of having the independence. And now a shift is happening. And the main shift that is happening is that they understand that they need these entrepreneurs to move forward. But on the other hand, they still want to control the entrepreneurs. And we're free minds, right? And we really believe that the challenges that we are resolving are not for government, are to better the lives of people, the lives of humanity. So it's really interesting to see like how the role of the government is going to decrease in time, and the role of corporations and entrepreneurs are going to increase. In terms of Angola, the best thing that could happen now are oil prices dropping and us losing oil, because we know what the oil, being the biggest oil producer, did to us. Better investments into infrastructure and public investments, high pricing. Luanda was the most expensive city in the world, and now we don't want to go back to what we had. So we really want to change. And this is coming with the youth, because we have a big youth population. Almost 55% of the population is under 15. So we have huge challenges to resolve for these 15 million people who are going to want a job in 10 years. What are we going to do? Either we create through entrepreneurship, you know, new relevant companies, or we can have a real crisis, worse than the oil crisis. So, I mean, for government, I just want them close but far away from ideas, because they're really bad regulating. They're really bad thinking about. So they need the support of the ecosystem to build it better.